seem like a lot of people go back here or know about it. We'll go see if anybody's back there. I think this is a trail that people made on their own. Nobody really knows about it unless you kind of explore it or you're a local. Thunder Basin grassland back here, so it's all state owned, something like that, government owned, I don't know. But none of it's private. There's a fence where it becomes private, and that's where this trail is at. Flying through here, it's going to be a little rough. Thing about riding a supermoto off-road is just being limber and kind of letting the bike do what it wants to do underneath of you. You know, it's gonna slip and slide, and it's just gonna go wherever it wants, and it's just kind of being loose and letting your body, you know, just, or the bike just kind of do what it wants to underneath the body. You try to control it too much and then it's just going to wear you out. That's where you're going to probably end up crashing, you know. People are actually going to really hear it, you know, if they're on a motocross bike or whatever, but at least by honking my horn, it kind of might, they might hear it. Say the only bad thing about this Righteous Stunt clutch, I don't have it on the easiest setting and only being one finger, kind of get arm pump a lot easier, but kind of started getting used to it after a while, but it's still wear you out by riding more technical trails. So I think if you're going to ride technical trails and you got a supermoto and you want this clutch, probably go with the two finger clutch. I think the two finger clutch would be a little bit easier. Or put it on the easy pull setting, but the problem I had with the easy pull setting is it just disengages like way too far back, and I don't like that. I like my clutch to disengage pretty quick. And this is where the trail comes right back out.